with the loss of 8-year-old Leila Fowler after she was found stabbed to death over the weekend in Calaveras County. Today, the tight-knit community of Valley Springs returns to work and school as authorities continue to hunt for her killer. The death of this young girl has the entire community on edge right now. KCRA3's Melinda Meza joins us live now from Valley Springs with the latest on this investigation and how the community is coping. Melinda?
Well, right now, everyone that we talked with in the community say they are concerned, they're on edge, and of course, they're hoping this killer will be found. Now, we are live here near where the girl's home is, right here down Ripon Road is where her body was found on Saturday. So 3 days later, the search is continuing, and people are still hoping to have that killer found. Now, students, of course, went back to class today on this Monday, and there were a large number of officers at the school and at the bus stop trying to keep people calm. Since the suspect has not been found, grief counselors will be on hand at Jenny Lind Elementary School for the students there and for the parents of those students. 8-year-old Leila Fowler was found dead in her home Saturday. She was found by her 12-year-old brother, who says an intruder was in their home. Now, this has many people in the community concerned, and some say they had to think twice before taking their child to school today.
Concerned about all the kids in the neighborhood, if for their safety. And there's a lot of parents who have to commute and go to work, and they are latchkey kids, so they come home and they unlock the doors.
Now, some parents say they have made other child care arrangements, and they'll continue to do that until this man is found. Some say they will be picking up their child from school today. Again, police have not found the killer. The investigation is still underway, and we're hoping to learn more this afternoon. Now, along here near the girl's home, you see ribbons, purple ribbons, black ribbons tied along because those were Layla's favorite colors, and so people say they're tying these ribbons in memory of her. Also, we could tell you there'll be a candlelight vigil tomorrow night at the girls' school, and that will begin at 7 p.m. So people here in the community are really gathering around this. Reporting live in Calaveras County, I'm Melinda Meza, KCRA 3 Reports.
Melinda, thank you.